Yo, what's up, everybody? Standing up here. Today, I'm going to be talking about Glover Teixeira versus Jamal Hill. This is going to be for the UFC vacant light heavyweight championship for 205 pounds because Magomed Ankalaev versus Jan Blachowicz went to a draw and Jiří Procházka vacated his belt so the guys can fight for it. Let's just get into it, guys. Both guys are 4-1 in their last five fights. Glover Teixeira has lost to Jiří Procházka. He lost his title in the fifth round with 28 seconds left. He lost by submission. And Jamal Hill, he basically lost by submission as well, but he gets Paul Craig, but like his arm almost fell off. I don't know what that was about. It was ruled a TKO, but it was a submission. Now it seems like both guys aren't great with on the ground, but Glover Teixeira, BJJ practitioner, very good on the ground, very strong wrestling, and he's very tough as well. He has been hurt multiple times in his last few fights against Thiago Santos. He has been hurt two times, but he has managed to get to the hips, get Thiago to the ground, and he ultimately submitted him in the third round, in the third round by rear naked choke. Jamal Hill, striker, good power. He has shown that against Thiago Santos, against Johnny Walker, and especially against Jimmy Crute, in my opinion, and before that against OSP as well. He has been on a tear, if we don't look at this fight at least. Especially the KO against Jimmy Crute, very precise, very fast, very powerful as well. Against Johnny Walker just doesn't have a good chin, so we can take that too much into account. And Thiago Santos was getting, he's pretty tired, so at some point he was going to lose. But man, the KO Jimmy Crute really impressed me. Very fast, very slick. You can't just run in against Jamal Hill because he will get you that way, man. And now Glover Teixeira isn't the guy to run in. He's very methodical. He j doesn't just go to the takedowns immediately. He is a guy that will, entertain some boxing, and I feel like he will, and that's very dangerous against Jamal Hill. I feel like that might be a mistake because Jamal Hill, he doesn't need time to, get into his groove. He just goes in there. He's locked in. He has multiple first round KOs against Jimmy Crute, against Johnny Walker, and a few fights before that. He isn't the guy that needs time, and Glover Teixeira, I feel like he kind of does. Maybe he needs like a jab or two to land for him to understand, like, yeah, I'm in this fight and let's get into it, But when he does, man, when he gets you to the ground with and he almost always does, even when he's hurt, his double leg is very good, very strong, and on the ground he is, his pressure is so strong. And I feel like if he gets a fight to the ground, that Jamal Hill will be kind of helpless there because he's, against Paul Craig he hasn't done any good. Against Thiago Santos he was getting out wrestled pretty badly as well, but Thiago Santos just got tired and Jamal Hill took advantage of that. I was not impressed with his performance, to be honest, because he was getting beat, but Thiago Santos is just not a wrestler. I feel like Glover Teixeira, he can go the five rounds, even if that's needed, but I don't think it will be. I feel like Glover will get like the neck or the arm or something because Jamal Hill does make mistakes when standing up, and I feel like Glover would just make sure to use those mistakes in his advantage and get a choke in. I feel like maybe second, maybe third round he will get a submission. And yeah, that's it. Glover by submission. That will be my, small little bet, but I wouldn't like bet on it. It's just for fun. And Jamal Hill, man, he could just clip him and get him out of there. So it's a very It's going to be very scary and good fight. So yeah, that was it. I will be making more of these for the other fights as well. So make sure to check them out as well.